What's up? This your boy Black C of the RBL Posse, one half of the legendary group RBL Posse. Black C, what's up with him? As far as Bay music, I think we lightweight. We lightweight, kind of, you know what I mean? I say we was making a comeback at one point, man, when we had the Jay Stylings, the D-Lows, the Jackers, and everybody was out at one time. Now it's kind of like everybody ain't really, it's been kind of quiet. So I feel like the status of Bay music is kind of idle right now. You know what I mean? I don't think we actually fell off. I just think we idle. We got a few new cats who kind of holding the torch. You know what I mean? The Sage of Gemini's, I Am Sue's, which is all in the same camp. You know, but as far as that grimy turf music, man, I think kind of been idle, been quiet, you know. The Mr. Fabs, the Keek, the Sneaks, you know, 40 still doing this thing, but ain't nobody really making an impact. You know, about the only one who is Sage the Gemini. And I feel like he kind of came out of nowhere, because I thought it was going to be I Am Suda pretty much that was going to kind of run with the torch. But Sage the Gemini was kind of like a surprise. He kind of keeping the torch lit right now for the Bay Area. But the Bay is kind of quiet to me, you know, as far as my opinion. I think we all kind of done fell back a little bit, you know what I mean? And I don't know if everybody just pretty much in the studio cooking up something or what's going on, but I don't know, it seemed like it swayed. The ball be swaying, it swayed from L.A., then it be in the Bay, and it swayed from the Bay back to L.A. It's like we never can't all do it at one good time, you know what I mean? Yeah, I feel as though we kind of quiet right now as far as Bay music. We ain't making no heavy, heavy impact. But you hear influences out there, though, for sure. I don't think it's been stolen, so I'm going to have to go with VD. Because I just think we influencing people, you know what I mean? I just think we might not be getting that much credit, but I don't think it's being stolen. It ain't no different than what we was doing early on when Ice Cube and NWA and everybody was coming out. You had people like 415 who was kind of, you know, Brother Broski, DJ Duro, and D-Loke, Richie Rich, all them was sounding almost like a Bay Area NWA when we first came out. We was imitating L.A. I mean, you know what I mean? We can't even lie about that. I mean, it was some people coming original, you know, with their own style. You had the E-40s and all them who came with a nice mob sound and kind of swayed it. But I just think we just not getting credit. But in music, you're going to always get influenced by what's hot. You know what I mean? And we had hot shit, and we wasn't even utilizing that old synthesized mob sound no more. Everybody started kind of going towards hyphy and different stuff. And just to kind of elaborate on, speak on as far as DJ Mustard and them, I don't think they pretty much, I mean, a lot of his music sound like some of my old stuff, some of Too Short and them. But I don't think he's just going through the files actually jacking. He, you know, LA was a heavy market for the Bay Area, so they was playing our stuff. But we wasn't really using it. We ain't using it no more. We went on to start copying Southern Sound and Lil John's and doing all type of other stuff. And, you know, I feel as though they using it right. They doing what they supposed to do. You know what I mean? It's West Coast. And I feel like as long as it's West Coast, I ain't mad at them. And even as far as like the people who using Mac Dre, I think that's just something when they come out here doing tours and all that. They know how much of an impact this made on the Bay Area. You know what I mean? They was like the kings of this shit. When it comes to movements, nobody moving was bigger than Mac Dre and what he had going on. So that's just getting passed down from the DJs and all them. They ain't just kind of using it like, yeah, I'm going to use this to get the Bay to love me, to get credit. It's kind of like, you know, I think they touching bases with Jay Diggs and Kilo Kurt and them, and pretty much, you know, they tapping in with them. You know what I mean? And I think them DJs like the Big Vines and, you know, DJ A-Mans and them, I think they putting that bug in their ear too. Like, you know, you might want to, while you out here, trying to kind of give it up for Mac Dre. Mac Dre was a big impact, even though they probably seen it. You know what I mean? They probably made a few ripples on the surface in their areas. But I think the Bay Area was so crazy about Mac Dre. Like, you know, he was like that next Pac. You know what I mean? When it came to it. So they feel it when they come out here. So I think they didn't have no choice. You know what I mean? Besides people, DJs and rappers being in their ear about it. I think it's just only, you know, giving credit. I don't think they actually just using it and abusing it, just, you know what I mean, taking advantage of it. I think they actually showing some respect, you know what I mean? And I ain't mad at them about that, you know what I mean? I ain't mad. I think we need to just get back, you know what I mean? I don't want to just sound fucking cliche or whatever and shit, and but it's like, man, we got to get back to doing what we used to do, making good albums. Right now, everybody, you know, motherfuckers ain't giving you a full course meal no more. It's all this soul food. I mean, it's all this fucking this microwavable type beats and music and shit, to where we ain't got no originality no more. Our identity is pretty much gone. Like I said, we get mad at other people for using our sound, but we ain't using it. We got to get back to using our sound, going back to that Mob, that Hyphy, you know, whatever we created. You know what I mean? A good gumbo mix of what we created, but knowing how to make it new and refreshing and remix it, and, you know what I mean, and get other rappers on our level instead of us trying to make Southern beats and shit like that and trying to get on their level and you know, making trap songs and all that shit. You know what I mean? We got to stick with our Mob sound and, you know, our funk sound we used to have back in the days. You know, not saying going back to throwback beats, but knowing how to recreate it and making it up-tempo, making it to where, you know, these females gonna wanna fuck with it. And, you know what I mean, making some club bangers without necessarily having singers and wanting to have singers on the hook and all that stuff. We got to know how to keep it grimy like we've been doing, but keep it up tempo to where, you know, you can take it to the club. So we just got to get our identity back, man. It ain't really no certain way of doing things. It's just that everybody just got to be working, and we got to stay consistent with it. Like right now, everybody quiet. You know what I mean? We ain't got that rhythm. We don't support each other. You know what I mean? It's like everybody rap right now. We done lost the fans. It's like right now when I try to promote, it's like every fan that I used to have is rapping now and want me to hear their shit instead of supporting what I'm trying to put out. You know what I mean? And that ain't nothing wrong with it, as long as we support each other. But once they start rapping, now you done lost that fan because they only care about their shit now. You know what I mean? And they crew. So it's just all about motherfuckers just kind of supporting each other like the South do, man. That's one thing I do love about the South, man. Even though they got their own movements going, their own entourages, their own sets, cliques, turfs, whatever they got going on, man, they support each other, man, and they welcome outsiders. We don't do that shit out here. We tear shit up. We tear shows up. We tear events up. Like, you don't get no support. You got to go to the South to party. You know what I mean? And it's like L.A. starting to see that a little bit. They trying to bring that type of little formula down that way, where you see the Crips and the Bloods kind of fucking with each other lightweight. You know, they got a nice little club scene down there. They can do their thing. You know what I mean? And we just got to do that shit in the Bay, man. The Bay is just too many fucking cutthroats out here, man. And motherfuckers ain't giving a fuck about nothing or nobody. They tan shit up. These youngsters don't care. And you know what I mean? They all misguided, man. There's a lot of motherfuckers just running around with like chickens with their heads cut off, not knowing what to do and who to get help from. And, you know, and a lot of them be like, man, I don't give a fuck about that rap shit. And when at one time used to be like, man, you can go hit turfs and motherfuckers is supporting you, loving you. Now it's like, shit, man, motherfuckers hating you. You don't want to hit the turf because you might fuck around and get hit up. So it's just all about us, man, trying to, you know, this atmosphere, man. It's just the atmosphere ain't right out here, man. We got to, you know, the whole Bay scene, man, just gotta be redeveloped. And I don't know if it's gonna take a song, an album, but you know, it's people like the leaders who we got right now are now leaders, like Fody and them, man. without them being involved, man, the people who are in the forefront, who really still selling albums, him, Too Short, it takes them to create a scene. They got to create a scene out here. They got to have clubs popping out here. They got to, like, you know, at one time 40 was fucking with the Beehive and sponsoring it and giving parties, at least hosting it or being there. It was something he was doing. We got to do more of that type of shit around here in Oakland and Frisco and San Jose and make them scenes to where the females gonna want to come out and fuck with us. You know what I mean? And we don't do that. You go down there, you got Jeezy on flyers, you got Gucci, man, you got fucking the Migos or whoever, man. You know, you got Migos, all these motherfuckers is just supporting Atlanta. Rocco, whoever, 2 Chainz, they support their own down there to where, you know, they going to clubs and spending money. We ain't doing that out here. We got to create a scene, we just don't know how to do it by ourselves. And it's going to take the big cats, man, out here, man, to do it. They got the ones that got to create the scene. If you know Richie Rich, Too Short, Be Legit, 40, and all these dudes on flyers and hosting parties, you're going to come out. I Am Sue, you know, Sage the Gemini, all the dudes that's cracking, actually making some noise right now. If they do more shit locally, man, the local scene will blow up. You know what I mean? But it's all about taming these lions, because we do got these lions and hyenas out here, you know, who ready to tear some shit up. So, you know, it's going to take some work, man. But, you know, I just think that's, as far as my opinion, I think that's the remedy, man. It's just getting out here and doing a lot of shows, and not even necessarily shows, just parties and shit like that. It ain't got to always be about rapping. Sometimes it's just all about being in the building, man, and just having a VIP spot and having motherfuckers come in and want to be next to E-40 and whoever else, you know, showing that they can ball too and spend money. You know, sometimes that's all it is, and just creating a fun atmosphere, you know.
Yeah, I can elaborate on it just a little bit, but I just think it didn't come out because Tupac died, you know. I think it was in the making. That's the reason why, and it wasn't going to be right without him, you know what I mean? So, you know, once he died, motherfuckers probably was in studios, raiding studios and everything, taking tracks and splitting shit up, you know. And I think that his shit just kind of got split up between the family, friends, and engineers, producers. And it just could, you know, because it take Pac to be that center person to bring all that shit together, because he was working out of a lot of different studios. You know, he'd be in New York and bang out 2-3 tracks. He'd be in L.A., bang out 10, 15. You know, Pac one of the motherfuckers, man, that's knocking shit out real fast. You know, doing a couple songs and shit in the night. So I'm thinking that the only way it didn't happen is because of, you know, what happened in Vegas. You know what I mean? I think if that shit wouldn't happen, I think it would have been big. I think that shit would have been real big, because he had, you know, the Bay in his hands. He had L.A., and he had a lot of East Coast motherfuckers who was fucking with him. And then that South shit would have fell through. You know what I mean? Or probably wouldn't. Ain't no telling. Pac was still here. Probably would have slowed the South up, but he still had people like Scarface and all them type motherfuckers who he was fucking with. So I just think that was really the reason why it didn't come out. I don't think nobody held it back, you know, intentionally. You know, like, oh, this shit ain't coming out, or I just think it just couldn't. It wouldn't have been right trying to put out that One Nation without him. You know, I just don't think that would even, it couldn't work without him. I mean, you know what I mean? Cut off the head and, you know the rest, shit. So he was the head, man. Without him, that shit is discombobulated, you know. But, yeah, that's my feelings on that.
One half of the legendary group RBL Posse, Black Seed, what's up with us? Welcome, cowards who's always friend, like talk behind our back. Scared to confront my strap, we can let it all react. We can take this.